Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our next speaker, Yevhen Sentiabov. And the topic for the presentation is alternative checkout flow. Please enjoy.
Hello, everyone. Today I would like to present the topic about the future vision of alternative Magento checkout. I will actually provide the, our vision, concepts, and ideas which we are going to and planning to implement. I understood that probably it's one of the last topics for today, so I will try to explain in some details. So. My name is Eugene Sentiabov, and I have been working in Magento last 4 years. The most of my focus area was like the payment integration, sales stuff, and the checkout, and actually why we're going to improve the checkout area. So the current Magento checkout has a lot of features, like one-page checkout with support from different shipping carriers, including USPS, UPS, FedEx, so on, multi-address checkout with online payment solutions, multiple payment integrations like PayPal, Braintree, AuthorizedNet, CyberSource, vault tokenization to use the storage of credit cards in a secure way, instance purchase with the ability to place an order from product page, and different security features like the anti-fraud protection and 3D secure verification. So, currently, Magento provides two multiple ways how to make the checkout customization. One of them is REST API, and another is GraphQL. Before the 2.3, 2.0 release, we had only one API. It was the REST API. And since the GraphQL was released, we get additional API. Like, currently, we have two APIs. So the problem in, like, the main problem that currently these two APIs use the same service contracts. And, like, sometimes these service contracts do not require, do not satisfy all our requirements and not always perform suboptimally. That's why they're thinking about alternative checkout flow and produce and release the new API based on GraphQL. So right now, our current step, current state is we are going to release 2.3.3, so it also like have as now two APIs, REST and GraphQL, and in some of the Magento future release, not earlier than 2.4.x, we will release the alternative checkout API. But before like talking about the alternative API itself, let's actually consider why we need this new API and why the current GraphQL and REST API do not satisfy all our requirements. At first, let's consider how the current checkout flow looks like. Our product page receives the product from the catalog, and the product page contains like the simple button add product to the cart. The cart, when we add product to the cart actions call the catalog to calculate, to get the product details like SKU, product name, price, so on, stock availability, for example, and which triggers the totals calculation because we need to calculate the price. The proceed to checkout action start the one-page checkout flow where the customer can provide a shipping address. Based on this shipping address, we can estimate the shipping rates, and this shipping rates estimation also calls the totals collector to recalculate the whole totals because like the, when the customer chooses the shipping address, shipping method, sorry, we need to calculate the whole totals. Oops. Something going wrong? Okay, so also here we have multiple steps, like the choosing the payment method, which like when we apply on the payment method step, we have different possibilities to apply gift cards, customer balance, so on. So it also triggers the total recalculation. And the problem that like we can see that the most of actions, even like page reloading triggers total recalculation, which decrease the system performance. So we have multiple actions which decrease the system performance, which make the checkout flow more slow. But like as I talk, we currently have two API. The first one is REST, and the second is GraphQL. And let's consider the difference between them on the simple example. For example, we want to achieve the products by a specific category, and to make it via REST, we need at least two multiple requests. The first request, we will get the category with category details, and the second request, we need to get the product details by this category. Actually, what two issues we are facing with this approach? The second one, that we need to at least two HTTP HTTP request, and the second is we can't limit the response data. Like in REST API, we have defined service contracts, and we can't limit only needed data. For example, we want to receive only product name, and SKU, and product price, but we will receive the whole entity. GraphQL works a little bit different way. We can specify the all needed data into one query or mutation, and we will receive, we can achieve the desired state with the same query. Because GraphQL provides a lot of possibilities like all resources are connected, we can retrieve the products for the category, we can retrieve the reviews for this product, so on. And like another features of GraphQL that we have declarative data fetching, we can define the schema, we can define the queries in our storefront application and use them. Also, as I said, we can perform multiple queries and mutation in the same request. But unfortunately, we are living not on ideal world, and there is some like not clear things in GraphQL that we can achieve the HTTP caching on the HTTP level because GraphQL doesn't support it. Another thing is API versioning. Today, probably you heard the heard the speech about GraphQL, and actually API versioning was like one of the features. But another thing that, for example, if we want to remove or rename some field, it might be tricky because we can't introduce the new API as all GraphQL exposed via the same schema endpoint. Another thing is, for example, if you want to implement some kind of rate limiting or defy the heavily loaded API, actually it might be very tricky because we have only one schema endpoint. We don't know how many clients use the schema endpoint and actually which queries they execute. So the next thing, like query complexity, it's hard to implement some kind of rate limiting because we don't know actually how much data the client application want to receive. During multiple requests, it can use the same query but the different list of fields. And again, the last thing that we actually don't know how many related resources the GraphQL query will request. But anyway, it's very good API, and actually our main point is like to use this API despite on some concerns about it. So let's consider multiple drawbacks about existing checkout implementation. Like probably you already familiar with this stuff. It's actually UI components in Magento, and this slide shows actually how to add the payment component to the checkout page. It shows only one billing step, but in general, the original checkout is much bigger. And for developers, it might be, it's only hard to debug it because you see just a lot of part of declarative XML schema. And like, it's very hard to customize something to find the extension points. Another thing, it's customization output. For example, we have the simple task like on the shipping step, we want to provide additional things like estimated delivery date. Currently, we have some shipping carriers, some prices for them, and we just want to add a simple field. We can use, as I said, multiple REST or GraphQL APIs, and for GraphQL API, it's easy to add additional field because you can declare some schema, you can declare some query, use additional resolvers to do it. The problem that as mentioned, in most cases, the REST API and GraphQL use the same backend service contract, and it's not always possible to improve them in backward compatible way. If you look much deeper in this example, actually we will find the final method which provides these shipping rates. And we see that a lot of fields are hard-coded, and like to achieve the desired state, we need to refactor a lot of code. That's the problem. We can't introduce new service contract in backward compatible way. We can't refactor them in like to satisfy our requirements. Another thing, it's difference between multi-address checkout and one-page checkout. Currently, multi-address checkout is based on the PHTML views, not like UI components for the one-page checkout. And few releases ago, we simplified this way. We added place order interface to support multiple online payment integration for the multi-address checkout. But the problem is that to be integrated to the multi-address checkout, the payment integration should support vault tokenization, and not all payment solutions support it. Another thing that on the API level, the cart and quote entity are the same entities are the same, so you can differentiate on the interfaces the cart and quote. And you probably in Magento you can find a lot of places where used is multi-shipping method, which actually checks if current checkout is multi-shipping or is like standard checkout. We don't have the clear API to define that we have multi-address checkout or not. And we always work, we have the same quote for the same customer at the same time. The current implementation doesn't provide to have multiple, doesn't provide the possibility to have multiple quotes for the same customer. And the all multi-address checkout is based only like on the shipping assignment for the same quote. The one of interesting thing is dependencies between different modules. Here you can see the different components, which like somehow it is take a part in the checkout flow itself. Here you can find the quote, checkout, catalog, so on. The blue arrow shows the unidirectional dependencies, and the orange arrow shows the multi-directional dependencies. So what's the problem actually is the we circular these dependencies. When we change one module, probably we affect another one. So we can't guarantee that when we need to fix something in, for example, catalog, we do not affect the functionality of the quote or the checkout model and so on. That's actually what we want to resolve. So what actually alternative checkout does mean? Probably today you like seen multiple times this picture. How in service isolation project we want to separate the storefront application to store management application, to deploy them separately, to develop them separately, to share replace some components to achieve the scalability, so on. I will consider some part of this application actually what. Related to the checkout functionality. So again, we will have some kind of cast of storefront like PWA. We have some kind of storefront application with the checkout functionality. Also, we are going to introduce the configure price quote component for the quote creation estimation, and it will be part of the functionality. And the something similar, we will have the store management application. We also have different requirements for these both applications. For example, for storefront application, one of the requirements that it should be independent application, so we can go through the whole checkout flow only having this storefront application without backend application. It should be hell available, it should be easy to scale. The components should be easy to replace, like we have the custom checkout or we have some kind of custom catalog, so on. And there is not should be synchronous communication between store management and storefront applications. One of the important thing is eventual consistency. Like today also you probably heard about it like multiple times. What actually does it mean? For example, we have the multiple applications like storefront applications, store management. Also we have different CRM, ERP system like Microsoft Dynamics, so on. And we have some like kind of middle application or could be just some layer application with message queue. And we have a case, for example, when admin creates a product. So it means like admin makes some write operation on store management application and somehow we need to send this data to storefront application. Storefront application is separate Magento application with own checkout, with own client like PWA or standard Magento checkout based on layouts. It has own like devices connected with like mobile devices, browsers, so on. And all clients always read this data from the storefront application. Storefront application doesn't have direct dependency to store management application. So some data might be not up to date because when admin just makes some write operation, it won't be immediately synced to the storefront application, but we're okay with that. Like we can assume that some data not up to date, okay. So, and the old synchronization is making in the background, it's background process, there is no direct communication. That's actually in simple words what is eventually consistency. Unidirectional flow. We saying that all data will go into like in one direction. So we will separate the cart from quote. The cart and quote will have own API, will have own life story. Like quote will have time to live and cart will have time to live. The catalog will receive, the cart will receive data from catalog, but quote won't have dependency to the catalog because quote will work with product information management and with inventory. The order also will receive the data for quote. So there won't be any more dependency from the order to the, for example, to the checkout some functionality because order should be processed like separately. And the quote will have knowledge about the different services like coupon service, customer balance service, discount, and so on. Let's consider how the alternative checkout flow will look like in the comparison to the existing checkout. So here we see that we have product inventory management and product information management and inventory management. And the catalog receives all data from this aggregate, like aggregate some kind of aggregated index. Like similar to the standard checkout flow, the product page renders some product, and we have possibility to add this product to the cart. So here right now, the first difference that cart doesn't anymore calls the totals collector. Cart will have some kind of simplified collector to just calculate prices, because actually when the customer just adds product to the cart, we don't need to call the whole inventory to define the price, because the price can be changed during checkout and customers should see the real price, like the exact price on the final checkout step when we actually will provide the quote estimation. So we can just use simple kind of calculation to just summarize the prices and just display them on the shopping cart. Again, simpler, we have the proceed to checkout action, customer can choose the shipping address, and here are the difference that we have a separate service to estimate shipping rates, and again, we don't call the whole estimator, we just provide the shipping rates. So now we have the payment select method step and the order review step. On these steps, we estimate the quote. We provide, we have a separate service to estimate quotes. It's called quotes estimator. And again, we don't have the calculation yet. And only we see the order review step. Like we provide the quote estimation, we calculate the total. And the, right now, the not quote have dependencies to different services, but each totals calculation will know about some specific details. Like, for example, shipping should use shipping estimator to calculate the actual shipping rates based on the chosen shipping method. Like cart price rule will use some coupon service to define if current coupon applied by customer is available, how the expiration date, so on, and when the expiration date, and so on. This is one of our goals to reduce the dependencies between modules, and we see here that the desired state is to have only single directional dependency, so when we will change some one module, it won't affect the behavior of another module. And the main goals and benefits are the better application performance, because we want to reduce the communication between different components, we want to simplify them, we want to avoid this additional totals calculation, so on. Also, we want to provide the clear API for cart, quote, to make them replaceable, to use different modules like SAP provides own quotes and own CPQ. Improved headless integration via existing GraphQL and new GraphQL. As like one of the GraphQL features is possibility to build one page checkout flow via one request. We can combine all queries and mutation to single HTTP query. As I said, separate API for cart and quote, multi-address checkout based on multi-quote flow. And one of the benefits of proposed approach that we can create multiple quotes for the same customer, so we will have multi-quote, and we can create this quote based on different factors. For example, if customer chooses multiple shipping addresses, we will create multiple quotes, each for different shipping addresses. And like we can estimate them separately and combine just one order, or just like make different orders dependent on the origin for the shipping. We can provide the different delayed payment transactions, so on. And one of the benefits, it's better API, better API for B2B scenarios, because right now all B2B scenarios based on the a lot of scenarios of B2B depends on the not API but the private implementation. One of the benefits one of the goals is introduce the clear API to build for easy building B2B scenarios, that we can use, for example, new quote API to build clear negotiable quotes, build requisition list. One of the tough thing in current Magento checkout and the quote estimation sets, it's total calculation. Probably know that Magento provides multiple ways how to calculate the totals. You can find in admin configuration like different tax calculation. You can apply taxes before shipping or after shipping. You can apply before discount, so on. Actually, if you look to the implementation, it's it's really hard to understand how the calculation works, and if you have complicated scenario with different car price rules, discount taxes, different shipping couriers, and so on, it's really actually without X debug and debugging, like I believe one day or maybe a few days, to understand actually how you achieve this price. The idea is to define the clear API and to visualize actually you can apply the multiple things and see, okay, I have such configuration, now I understood how my price calculated for some different products. So here you can see that we will provide some kind of, we will have, the totals will be separated from quote, and we will have the separate API for quote calculation and separate API to work with totals. These totals can be in the future applied for different entities like order, payment, invoice, credit memo, so on. Here you can see that each calculator will receive the quote object to get only the data and the totals list, and each calculator will create new totals, total object, like for example, we have subtotal. We'll have separate calculator to calculate just only subtotal. We have tax calculation. We will have separate calculator to calculate just taxes. And all this calculation will be added to the total list, and in general, developers will work not the separate totals, but they will work with total lists. So any needed on the any needed step, you can like just get needed totals for some. For example, you want to show in the order estimated, quote estimated page, you can just show different type of taxes depending on the region, depending on some tax rules. You can get just needed taxes and show the whole amount. Another requirement that. Totals calculation depends on the different scenarios. For example, we have multiple scenarios, like you can provide the configuration via admin panel, but also it depends on the checkout itself. For example, we shouldn't calculate the totals for the virtual products, shipping rates totals for the virtual products because the virtual products do not have the estimate, the delivery. Like the customer can download from website and we don't need to call shipping carriers to provide some rate because we actually don't need to deliver this product. So one of the requirements that all calculations should be built in runtime. Also, quote and totals will be immutable object. They won't change their state. It would allow us to create always new objects, and it would allow us to have the clear behavior without some kind of magic behavior behind, because if you look in the current implementation, there is a defined list of totals, actually the priority of totals, and you can see that, for example, it's obvious thing that grand total should be the last calculation because you already applied all discounts, all gift cards, so on. But in the current implementation, you can find that, for example, customer balance have bigger priority than when the grand total, and it actually changes the grand total, the quote object. But the customer balance should calculate only applicable customer balance, but actually change the grand total. So it's wrong implementation. And we can change in the backward compatible way right now. So as I said, we will use the immutable objects for the quote and totals list, and like consider the difference between mutable and immutable objects. Mutable objects can be updated any time after creation. You can use just simple setter methods to specify some data, some dependency, so on. They are cheaper for creation because you don't need all data during the object initialization. They are easy to implement because, unfortunately, most of the developers use the setter method just to provide some dependency or data, and they are easy to extend. Immutable objects, they don't change their state. They simpler to create, test, and use during the initialization. They help to avoid temporal coupling. They don't have side effects, as you can't change the state of object. You just receive the data from it. The data in immutable object easy to cache, and maybe not so actual for PHP world, but they trade safe, so we can use some kind of parallelization to make some simultaneous operation. And thanks for Ricardo Tempesta. He already made some good work to provide the immutable DTO and auto-generated interfaces in Magento, so probably in some next future we will see this possibility in the core implementation. So actually, here you can see how the totals list will look like. We will have the total interface, which provides few methods to get amount, check if totals are applicable so they can be calculated, and each separate total will be represented as dynamically created DTO object with own purpose, like shipping total, subtotal, taxes, so on. And as I said, developers will work with totals list interface to get all totals or get like some only part of totals. Also, totals list will provide the methods to get currency exchange rate, weight currency, so on. And here you can see how the totals calculator will be implemented. It will be presented as a composite. The factory will provide the possibility to create different calculators based on the flow and configuration. So the and each calculator will calculate the specific total and it will add it to the totals list. Here you can see then how the totals will be represented. The big difference that we want to store the totals as a JSON structure in the database, database table. For example, the current quote table contains 28 fields related to the totals. You can find the totals for the base currency, for totals with shipping amount, tax amount, so on. The main idea to store everything in JSON, store everything in base currency. Also, this JSON object will contain currency exchange rate and display currency. Here you can see that some totals might be applicable or not applicable. And one of the difference that right now Magento stores all numbers related to some kind of totals as float. So we will store as integer. It would allow us to avoid 1 cent issue as we won't have the rounding. Also, it would allow us to support zero decimal currencies out of the box. It's not so actual like from European or United States, but it's this actually the problem for the Asian countries, like for example Japan, which uses yen. It doesn't have the like we use cents, so some kind of that. And how we actually will store the totals? As I mentioned, we will separate totals from the entities. Totals will be stored in the separate table, and each entity will have the relation to these totals. One of the approaches how to implement it is just add to a relational table with entity ID and the entity type. Because entity ID doesn't guarantee the uniqueness across different tables, we can have the same ID for, like, for example, for order, quote, or credit memo. How we can avoid it? We can use UEID. It guarantees uniqueness, and we do not need any more this additional relation table. So each entity will have own unique ID called UEID. And the benefits of UEID are it guarantees uniqueness across not only tables, but also databases and applications. It's environment independent, so we can generate with usage of any language or any data storage. We know the value before entity is saved, so we can make all the saving operation in the background and use without committing the entity to the database, without saving to the database, we can use this ID for the future scenarios. The value itself doesn't expose the entity information, so we can use, for example, on storefront, we can use this UEID to show like the relation between different entities, and it won't expose the entity information. It's suitable for distributed systems, but there are multiple drawbacks, like it takes up more storage because it like integer is very optimized in the databases. UEID in most cases stored as binary, so it takes more space. It's more difficult for debugging because developers will see in the database binary value, and it actually doesn't say anything. And it's less performant than auto-increment. And actually, this is the main drawback about UEID usage. We made some research a few years ago to compare how UEID can be suitable for the Magento. At that time, we decided to don't implement it because it was not good. Didn't have good performance as we expected. Now I made some benchmarks again. I compared standard auto-increment key and UEID usage for MySQL 8 and MySQL 5.7, and we can see that it's not so fast as auto-increment key, but the performance is pretty good because databases are evolving and probably. Again, we are thinking about to use it again. So to summarize, the new vision of JSON count would allow us to improve the performance because we will redesign some scenarios, we will improve the communication between components. Also, we have intention to make components replaceable that different merchants can use own implementation or extension even written in different languages, just work with API. It would allow us to have the improved and separate API for cart and quote. Also clear boundaries between them that developer can use own cart implementation or own quote implementation provided like by different third-party systems. Unidirectional flow would allow us to have only like strict one-way communication between components, support multi-algorithms out of the box without any like life hacks and just to have the API, the unified interface for totals calculation to simplify our life, and the simplified and unified for storage calculation, total storage. That's all. Thank you for your attention, and probably we have some time for questions.
Thank you. So yeah, we have some time for questions. Please welcome to ask them.
Hello, thank you for the speech. You mentioned about multi-shipping thing and quotes which could be merged and so on. Will it be introduced or it's just an idea? Because we faced it several times on huge projects with complex logistics systems and multi-shipping address is not that thing which would help to resolve such a situation.
We actually have the strong intention to do it because we also like working even in the base vanilla Magento installation. We also have multiple cases when we need this multi-quote. For example, as mentioned, the existing multi-address checkout, it's actually very hard to integrate some online payment solution because if you don't have vault, probably you can do it, but you probably will facing a lot of fraud transactions. So to make like the good support, like the good out of the box support, even for current multi-address checkout, we already need this multi-quote support. Like we also have the multiple B2B scenarios, like the negotiable quote, when the merchant just want to compare, apply different rules and want to compare which quote is cheaper, like which product might be delivered faster, so on. So we already need this, and like we have the strong intention to implement it.
Thank you.
Hello. Hi. Thank you for your presentation. It was very informative. I have a question. Does this alternative checkout flow will impact how we create order from the admin panel?
We will separate the, like, as I mentioned, we will have the storefront application and the store management application. So right now, the more focus on this checkout itself, because probably Anton Igor today already mentioned that merchants, the big merchants want to have storefront, like Magento only storefront, but it will actually impact the how the place order flow looks on admin panel, because right now they use the admin, it's not checkout, but the admin place order flow and the checkout on storefront, they simple, but sometimes, like in some cases, they're different. The thing that they use the same API. And if you want to change something on storefront, probably you will affect the, some behavior on the backend. That's why when we divide this API, we will change something on the admin side. Because we still want to have the admin place order flow to support the existing behavior because merchants use it. And probably it will be two different APIs. But some part, like, because for example, they use the same payment integration. And in most cases, if you're not talking about additional additional security features, like for example, 3D Secure, they look the same, the payment. So we don't need to write two different integration to make the same thing for storefront and for admin management, order management. So yeah, it will be different from the API level, but I believe that, like, the flow in general will look the same, and it will be optimized because the admin place order flow has the same problems as the checkout.
Cool, thank you.
Thank you for the presentation. I have a question regarding how this simplification or separation of totals collection and shipping estimators, how this stack up with the when we have a complex situation when shipping methods should be calculated or maybe shown only specific shipping methods depending on what products in cart. So if we have only shipping estimator when it's separated out of it doesn't know basically much about the what's in the cart, how in this flow which it will it will work.
So I would like to divide my answer to two parts. The first thing that what exactly is the purpose of the shipping estimator? What the kind of data it will it should use? Like the simple thing that it received the origin, destination, and some item dimension, and just provide the available prices based on this data. So that's one part. The second part, probably it's already like aligning to the existing implementation. We have the sales, which you can configure, and based on that, you can change the price of shipping. So like I believe in general, it will be implemented in the same way. It just will be clear that you have some kind of set in the shopping cart, and you can you want to convert this shopping cart to the quote, and you will apply these rules for the quote, not to the cart. But again, you can use this estimation for even like the currently Magento Pro shows the shopping cart page. Actually, it's not a shopping cart, but it's already created quote because we don't have the entity like the cart. And you can like, see like tax estimation, shipping estimation shown, so on this shopping cart. So the idea is that you will have the API to do the same thing for the same shopping cart on the API level. It's already quote, but on the checkout step, just like for the customers to select cart. So like answering to your question, you will have some kind of pipeline. The first thing, you will calculate the prices from available shipping methods and the shipping carriers. And the second, you will just apply the configured sales rules to these prices. And this calculation will be just, I didn't show that we will have the interface to see actually how it will look like in JSON, how actually the order of calculation happened, and you can actually represent on some, for example, in admin panel, you might represent different scenarios and to see how the actually totals were calculated. So that's the idea.
Okay, thank you.